Hello, everybody. It is 4:11 p.m. Central Time on Tuesday, January 3rd, 2017. And I've got you looking here at Earthquake 3D, and we're looking at a very large 7.2, 7.3 magnitude earthquake that just struck west of Fiji. And I would like to point out to everybody that we issued a warning last night for the area to the west of this letter D for the potential of a 7.3 to 8.3 earthquake. And now a 7.3 has struck. Now the reason this 7.3 or 7.2 earthquake struck is because of yesterday's deep 6.3. And the deep 6.3, as we said, will lead to 1 to 2 magnitudes larger in the nearby area to the west. And the area to the west has now been hit. This means that the area around the deep earthquake needs to be on heightened alert. This includes down near New Zealand for the potential of compensation movement, as we talked about in last night's update. So if you want to see last night's update, you can jump over to my YouTube page where the specific warning was issued. And I'm just going to go ahead and show you guys, just in case you missed it or didn't catch it. This now makes 2 7.0 earthquakes today. One was not reported out in the Pacific. Another one now has been reported, and this is significant. This is, the noteworthy sized earthquakes that we were looking to happen. So I'm going to bring you over to my YouTube page, and here's my video from last night. And about, a good portion of the video is dedicated to this area in the West Pacific surrounding this deep earthquake. And so if you want to check it out, it's titled 1-2-2017 Nightly Earthquake Update and Forecast, Week of New Unrest Coming, New Deep Earthquakes. And now the result of this is a 7.3, 7.2 to the west of the deep earthquake by several hundred miles to the west. Let's go check the National Data Buoy Center. National Data Buoy Center, buoy. And this will bring us up. Top search should bring us up the National Data Buoy Center. And we'll see if we have any buoys in event mode right now. Okay, no buoys in event mode right now. That's good. And we wouldn't expect a very large wave off this, not any kind of tsunami. If there was, it would be a couple foot high at the most. In the past, when we see shallow 7, 7.2, 7.3, causes a 2-foot tsunami, 3-foot high tsunami, nothing major. I mean, you might get a bigger wave off a storm system. But I think this is proof in the pudding that the deep earthquakes cause shallower, larger movements, sometimes several hundred to 1,000 miles away. So you can see west-northwest of our deep earthquake from yesterday. Let me turn down the rings so you can really get a better idea of where the deep earthquake occurred and where our shallower, larger earthquake has now developed. So it is. It's about 500 to 800 miles away to the west. And this means, New Zealand, you also need to be on watch. Okay, so this fully confirms everything that we were talking about watching for right now. Now, over the next several days, like I said, for the next few days, we are watching for the potential of a 7.9 to develop out over here to the west. But already, I mean, this is the confirmation that this deep earthquake is now fanning pressure upwards and outwards. This is day one after the deep earthquake. So first day after the deep earthquake, we see a shallower, larger 7 strike right next to it. I would say that is related. Not just say that's related, it is related. Same time that's all going on, we're seeing pressure transfer over to the East Pacific, and it's hitting in South Chile with hardly any activity to the north. And they just upgraded the 7, one of the earthquakes. They changed the location slightly to the west a little bit more. You're going to hear this ding several more times. One other thing I'd like to point out. Somebody asked me about why Perth was hit. Well, guys, there was deep earthquakes on all sides north of Australia yesterday. And I reported on this last night. And, they're not all on the map today, thanks to the Europeans being the ones that report this and USGS not. But there were deep earthquakes yesterday surrounding the area north of Australia. And the whole plate of Australia was pushed up Yes. And that has caused movement along the perimeter on a 4.5 level. That's why you got a rare 4.5 down in New Zealand following these deep earthquakes yesterday. One other thing I'd like to point out, there's been a cluster of new deep earthquakes today. So the cluster of deep earthquakes topping out at 4.9, there was also a 4.7 and a 4.5. This is on top of yesterday's 6.3. So we have the potential to go up into the sixes still over the next few days off this new round of deep earthquakes today. So the 7 is a result of what happened yesterday. We got more deep earthquakes today, meaning more pressure is coming. We are not done yet. There's going to be more movement. If you're in Japan, if you're in Philippines, if you're in Indonesia, guys, look, deep earthquakes cause shallower, larger earthquakes. The whole area from Asia over to Fiji moved yesterday with deep earthquakes, which means shallower, larger earthquakes are coming. It's a good idea to be prepared. If you're on the west coast of the U.S., listen up. If you're on the west coast of Central America and South America, whenever we see movement like this over here in the West Pacific, it compensates over to the east, which means the area where our arrows are needs to be on watch. And the area to the south, I mean, I don't even need to tell you that, to the south, the area to the north where it's quiet, where Central America meets South America, look, guys, be on watch. And California, we're watching for that 5.5 to hit right along the coast. Then we're watching for a 6.0 to hit. Now that the 7s are hitting, it might just go straight into 6s and skip the 5.5. Okay? As I'm talking here, the eastern edge of the European Craton has just been struck by a 4.0, 3.9. That's in Macedonia, I believe. I think that's Macedonia. Hold on. Hold on. Let's get our earthquake information on this. Okay. Bulgaria. Sorry, guys. Sorry, Bulgarians. Okay, so it struck in Bulgaria, right at the Romania border. This is along our European Eastern Craton edge. Now, it's far enough to the south, it should push to the west into Italy, but it also should go up and around. We'll see a split on this occur, and we'll see similar-sized earthquakes strike on both sides of this new 3.9. Most likely more to the south, across Italy, going across the Aegean Sea. So, in between, okay, pretty obvious. And when we go over to the west, we're going to watch up in Poland again. It was hit yesterday, should be hit again today. Okay, so just be on watch, guys. This is significant. I'm going to go save this as a video on my channel for future reference as another example of how our deep earthquakes cause shallower, larger movement within a couple days' time. And in this case, yesterday's deep 6.3 caused today's shallow 7.3. Now downgraded to 7.2, whatever. So there we are. I hope you guys feel confident in getting the warnings out. As I told you last night, I take the warnings serious. And anytime we see deep earthquakes like this, and it's followed up with shallower, larger movement, it's a good idea to warn the planet. It is. It's a good idea to warn the regions, and it's a good idea to warn the people across from the regions that it could be coming their way. You can see this transfer like a roadmap. So it goes from the letter D out to the west and down to the south. New Zealand should get hit. New Zealand should get hit. And the areas to the west should get hit with the expected magnitudes. And take a look at the spots that haven't been hit yet. And those are the spots we're going to need to watch for new movement. This includes Japan again. Okay, so things are about to go through the roof. And it looks like they already are. This is the last 24 hours worth of earthquakes. Here's the last 24 hours. Here's the last 24 hours of earthquakes. I mean, it's pretty obvious things are speeding up a little bit, aren't they? So there's our large earthquake, guys. There it is. One of them. One of them. The closest one to the deep earthquake. But the central spot in between all of this, the one where we're looking for a 7.9, obviously hasn't hit. But same time that's going on, due north of here, and I mean almost due north, follow this white line up. We just had a 7.7 out here. 7.7 here, and then a 7.2, 7.3 here, within a few hours of each other. That is related. It is. And we're not going to discount that 7.7 as being an erroneous mistake when we have a 7 due south of there within a few hours. Right, guys? Apply science. Apply Occam's razor. Simplest solution. What's the simplest solution? Not that they're keeping, they're keep on detecting repeat error earthquakes in the same spot. No, that they are trying to hide that 7.7, and now they can't hide it because an earthquake struck in a spot where there's people, and right next to an island populated with people. I would say they can't hide that one, while they can hide the one out here in the middle of the Pacific. So two sevens, same day, so that we're looking for a 7.9. 7.7 and a 7.3, by the way, adds up to 7.9, in case you guys didn't know. Take the 7.7 plus another 7, brings it up to 7.8, right? And then add in this the 0.7 and the 0.3, and that takes you right to 7.9. And that's what we're looking for over here in the West Pacific today. Did it happen? Sure did. Sure did. They can't hide it anymore. Now they can't hide it. Unless you believe that the first 7 was just an accident. And if you believe in those kind of accidents, hey guys, you know, I got a bridge. It's in Brooklyn. It's for sale. You can charge a toll on it and make all your money back, but you got to pay me cash, and I'll send you the deed later. Got that deed somewhere. I don't know. Yeah, it was given to me by George Washington himself. Back before it was even New York. Yeah, I'm a time traveler too, in case you didn't know. All right, guys. Much love to everybody, and I'm going to save this as a video on my channel now, get the warnings out to the people that the areas that we're looking for to be hit are being hit now, and the largest earthquake to strike in the past week and a half has hit right next to our deep earthquake. Sign number one, that pressure is spreading out. And if pressure is spreading out, it's only a matter of time before it follows these lines out towards the regions that we've warned. Okay? How many people are in here right now? Hopefully there's enough people in here to get the warning out. 1,000 people are in here right now. 988 people. Get the warnings out. Go over to my channel. I know, it's a pain in the ass. Go over to my YouTube channel. Go get last night's video and share it with everybody you know. And say the first earthquake you warned for has already hit. Please keep watch over this week in the other areas we named. So it's going out in a progression. From this big earthquake now, it's going to go out from there. Okay? So be on watch. And I'm not exaggerating. Deep earthquakes lead to shallower, larger earthquakes. The proof is in the pudding. It's here again before your eyes. Can you believe they denied it? Can you believe Professor John Vidali came over and said deep earthquakes don't cause shallower, larger earthquakes? Can you believe that? That to me is the most wild thing in the world. Saying that earthquakes don't progress when we can see them happen on the map. So be on watch, have your plans dusted off if you live on the West Coast, if you live in Japan, if you live over in Philippines. The reason you need to be prepared is because a new round of deep earthquakes has struck across the West Pacific over the past 2 days. 4 yesterday, 3 today, plus the big one. Okay, so that's 8 different deep earthquakes in the last day and a half. That means bigger movements coming. It's here on our doorstep. You can see it on the screen here now. Okay, see you guys back in just a few. I'm going to save this on my channel. You can share this as a video as well on my confirmation on the area that we named.